Welcome to my first class of 4-year series. My name is Dr. K.M. Rupa. I'm working as a professor and head, Department of Mathematics, Bangalore Institute of Technology, Bangalore. Now, before we are going to start actual 4-year series, first you have to know why you need to study for 4-year series, who is invented 4-year series, why they introduce compulsorily for all the stream of engineering course. Even though you are at basic science means BSc, there also we are studying 4-year series. This 4-year series invented one of the author is a French mathematician. Author is nothing but Joseph Fourier. This way they give this method name is 4-year series. Series means in this method, whenever we have to apply this method, the given function we are going to express in terms of infinite number of terms. Therefore, we treated this method. This method is, they give a name is nothing but Fourier series. Fourier is a name of the author. Series is comes from this method is, once you apply this method, we is involving infinite number of terms. Therefore, we treated as series. Totally, this method is they consider as Fourier series. Now, this Fourier series is very much useful in all the stream, and also why you need to use this method. If you have any periodic function, if you want to express that periodic function in terms of simple sine and cosine waves form, there we are going to use Fourier series. Therefore, Fourier series are a method of representing periodic functions. It is very useful and powerful tool in the domain of engineering and science, or periodic in nature. Means function must be a periodic function. For example, simple example, current and voltage existing in an alternating current circuit. We can analyze these periodic functions into their constituent components by using a process called Fourier analysis. The Fourier series is a mathematical way to represent non-trigonometric periodic functions as a finite sum of trigonometric functions. Means, suppose the given original, the given function is a periodic function, is not a trigonometric function, say x square, e power of x, like that. In such cases, if you want to express that non-trigonometric function as a sum of infinite number of terms of trigonometric functions, there we are going to use Fourier series. Suppose the given function is not a periodic function, there we are going to use, instead of Fourier series, the another method is called Fourier transform. The overall, we have to consider Fourier series is one of the mathematical tool to take a decision in your core subject. Whenever we want to express that function in terms of simple wave, sine wave and sine and cosine waves, there we are going to use Fourier series. Even though it's non-trigonometric function, if you want to express in terms of trigonometric functions of infinite number of terms, there we are going to use Fourier series. Whenever you want to solve differential equation or ordinary or partial differential equation, there also we are going to use one of the method is nothing but Fourier series. Therefore, overall the conclusion is Fourier series is one of the mathematical tool to take to represent non-trigonometric or maybe a trigonometric periodic function. Keep in mind, if you want to go for Fourier series, the function must be a periodic function. Otherwise, you can't go for Fourier series. But in your level, in engineering level, not necessary to verify whether the function is a periodic function or not in the given interval. What are the function problem they are going to discuss in the engineering course or engineering textbook, they already verified such type of function only they consider to find the Fourier series. In your level, not necessary to verify is a periodic or not. But we have to know that if you want to go for in the core subject, Why you had to go for Laplace transform? Why you had to go and study for Fourier series? Why you had to study for Fourier transform? That's why I'm explaining here. But while going taking problem, what are the function is already verified, the periodic function, such type of function only we are discussing in engineering level textbook. Okay, move to the next. Now I'm considering some applications of Fourier series. Let us consider first computer science engineering. Here I'm not considered all the application, only I'm quoted some few application. The first application is MP3 encoding and also sound processing. In such cases, they're going to using Fourier series to take a decision. Not only that, transmissions and processing signals, in this case also they're going to using Fourier series. And also time domain convention also they're going to use Fourier series. And also another method, cryptography. One of the topic is nothing but cryptography. Why you have to use cryptography? You are passing a secret message from one end to another end. There also they are going to use one of the method, mathematical tool is nothing but Fourier series. They are going to use numerical method also. Some of the case they are going to using Fourier series, they are going to pass a secret message for cryptography from one to another end. Well, for one end to another end, okay? And move to the application of Fourier series in civil engineering. Civil engineering students, while solving vibration problems, they're going to use Fourier series. We can find frequency of earthquake. I'm come to that point later. Using rainfall forecasting. For taking decision for rainfall forecasting, they're using Fourier series. The electronics, electrical and telecommunication and EI students, they're going to use following some applications, that's all. Signal processing, image processing, vibration analysis, econometrics, thin wall shell theory, and also electrical engineers, especially they design complex power systems using Fourier series. Whenever they're having complex power system, how to take very easily the outcome, they're going to design using Fourier series. They're going to find out good output from using this Fourier series. And also I'm giving some quoted figure here. Time domain, see, we are actually basically our Fourier series involving team is time domain. We are converting time domain to frequency domain, time domain to frequency domain. Once you conversion of time domain to frequency domain, we are going to use so many mode. One of the mode Laplace transform, the another mode is Fourier series, next another mode is Fourier transform, fast Fourier transform, wavelet transform, so on. Now here, once you apply for while converting time domain to frequency domain, you can't convert directly. We have to use any one of the mode. Here we are using Fourier series. While applying Fourier series for time domain, once you convert into frequency domain, we get a solution in terms of, that is nothing but frequency domain. How we get that frequency domain from time domain to frequency domain? For example, first one, pulse. Suppose pulse in the time domain, once you apply the mode for Fourier series, we get a frequency domain this form. Similarly, square. Suppose you apply square for the Fourier series, they convert into this form of Fourier series. Triangle. Once you apply for triangle form of the waves, then we get actually frequency domain for this form. Similarly, swath. Once you apply that, we get this form of, once you apply the Fourier series, we get this form. Rectified, once you apply the Fourier series, we get similarly cosine y wave. Apply the Fourier series, finally we get this form. Similarly, sine wave, apply that, we get another waveform of another form of Fourier series. These are the comes very much useful, especially for electronics, electrical, EI, and telecommunication students. Okay. Move to the next and the last application of Fourier series, mechanical engineering and also IEM. Heat conduction, analyzing mechanical system acted on by periodic external forces. There they are going to use Fourier series. Shock wave analysis, actually shock wave analysis comes under physics also, heat transfer. In these cases, they are going to use what actually Fourier series. See, now before I'm going to stop to explain the application, now you I'm displaying this website link. Just you put this link in Google, immediately we get you get actually, just if you want, I'll show it, give me 1 minute time. Yeah, I go to Google. Yes, add. Now, just you paste it, zip file, then showing that how this is our wave. That wave is how they convert into, once you apply the Fourier series, you take first two terms, three terms, or four terms, finally they reach what they expect once you apply the Fourier series. Just now I discussed, no? For cosine wave, how we get converted, once you apply the Fourier series, how they converted into in the form of whatever frequency domain. This is a thing. Similarly, you go for sine and different what I we observe, no? Same thing is possible. I go for what about zip file is available, number of zip file where in the internet you search and you go through that. Okay, now I'm going to start to share the application oriented thing. I'm going to explain the prerequisite of Fourier series. Before I'm going to go for prerequisite, I want to share one point. I told I'm going to explain later. See, when you analysis of earthquake, we go in civil engineering, we are using Fourier series. See, observe carefully. For electronic students, once you want to know signal processing, we get a waves. We get a waves for signal processing. In mechanical engineering, mechanical vibration, we get a waves. Simply, I'm writing some one wave, that's all. And also, what about our civil engineering student, they want to give what's a life of bridge. They are what's a life of this building. What they going to do, better to take a bridge for civil engineering. They're going to put a one machine in near to the bridge. They're going to collect the moving the vehicle for two wheelers, four wheelers. Once you collect the two wheelers, four wheelers, they convert it into waves. Once you that mission is converted into waves, once you convert in the waves, they by using Fourier series, they're going to take addition how many years life is having a bridge like that. If you want to see, here also we get a wave, here also we get a wave, mechanical vibration also get a wave, signal processing also get a wave, whatever bridge they convert into in the form of wave, finally we get a wave. They're going to use one mode, common mode is a mathematics. Using mathematics, they're going to take addition. The one of the tool is nothing but Fourier series. Okay. Now move to the prerequisite. What's the meaning of prerequisite? Prerequisite means if you want to study for Fourier series, before going to study for Fourier series, what are the previous knowledge you required to understand Fourier series? That is nothing but prerequisite. Prerequisite you already studied in your first year level, and also you studied where you already studied in a PU level, all the things. You studied all the things in first year and thing. Therefore, then easy to understand. Therefore, before I'm going to start today class, I'm going to explain how to, what are the prerequisites are required in where in Fourier series. Okay. Now, the very first definition is even and odd function. Even and odd function. Even and odd functions. Okay, fine. Yeah. When you consider the given function is even function, when you consider as the given function is odd function, The first thing is the function must be defined in negative to positive interval, say minus a to a. That is a very, very important. Most of the students, they're doing mistake. They are not worried about the interval. Simply, they consider a function. Before going to verify the function is even or not, first you observe the interval, whether the interval having negative to positive interval, then only I go for even or odd. Suppose f of x is defined in the interval minus a to a. Now, once you replace in the given function x by minus x, after replace x by minus x, we get the same function, then we treat it as an even function. This is what type of function? Is an even function. For example, f of x is cos x. F of x is cos x. Now, once you replace it x by minus x, you already know that what is cos of minus x is cos x. We get same function. Therefore, cosine functions are even functions. Similarly, I have to take x square. Now, I keep in mind this cosine function we consider negative to positive limits. The next move to see how it look like graphically for suppose the function is an even function. Suppose the function is an even function, how is look like for even function? Yes, like that they look like even function. It's clear? Now move to the next one, odd function. Yeah. Once you replace, again I'm going to take same function f of x is defined in the interval minus a to a. Once you replace x by minus x, we get minus of f of x. Then you consider the given function is an odd function. For example, f of x is sine function. Now what happened? F of minus x is sine of minus x. So what is sine of minus theta is minus sine theta. Therefore, this is nothing but minus of f of x. Therefore, sine functions are what type of function? Is an odd function. How is look like is our odd function? Odd function is look like for this way. Yeah, you take any different form like that. It's an odd function. Okay. Now this is an even, this is odd. Yeah, different figure also you have to consider. The next step is now after even or odd. Suppose I have to replace. Suppose the function is defined in the interval minus a to a. Once you replace x by minus x, we get not equal to minus of f of x, not equal to f of x. Then we have to consider the given function is neither even nor odd function. That's also very, very important. If we want to verify, it must be defined in negative to positive interval. Before moving to the next step, I want to share with some more thing because that is very much useful while solving problems in Fourier series. Yeah. Suppose if first case f of x is odd function, is odd function. Okay. Now I'm consider g of x is an even function. Even function. This is odd function. What happened the product of these two? What product of odd into even, what happened? F of x is an odd function means what? F of minus x is equal to minus of f of x. G of minus x is an even function. Therefore, what is g of minus x is g of x. Once you take the product, what happened? F of minus x into g of minus x is nothing but what we get actually minus into f of x into g of x. Is what is an odd function. It's an odd function. Therefore, product of even into odd or odd into even, that resultant is what? Odd function. Suppose I take second one, f of x and g of x, both are odd functions. Both are odd functions. Now what happened? Both are odd function means f of minus x is minus f of x. G of minus x is what actually? Minus g of x. Now, you take a product, f of minus x into g of minus x. Now, what we get actually? minus into minus, we get f of x into g of x. We get same function. Therefore, the product of two odd functions is a even function. And next, the last one, what happened? These things are very, very important. Suppose we are to consider both the functions are even. That is very easy. Both the functions are even function. What happened? The product of f of x and g of x, we get same thing. It's a product of two even functions, must be even functions. Even function. Now here, for example, better I to take now, before I move to the next thing. Now for example, for first case, for the product of odd into even. Now we are better to consider one simple example in all three cases. Choose f of x is x and g of x is sin x. What happened? F of x into g of x, both are defined in the negative to positive limit. Odd into odd, what we get actually? F of minus x into g of minus x, what we get actually? Minus x minus sin x minus into minus plus, what we get? X into sin x. We get a same function. Therefore, product of two odd function must be even. If you want to take an example for product of one is even, another one is odd. Suppose I have to take f of x is x and g of x is cos x, then what happened? The product of these two, f of minus x and g of minus x, what we get actually? Minus x into cos x, because x is an odd function. Okay, fine. In the product of two even function, that is very clear. So for example, f of x is equal to x square and g of x is cos x. Product of these two function, we get an even function. Still you have a confused, I'm going to write one simple relation. Just to remember that relation, then we have to overcome confuse. What we are get, what's the product of two even function, what is product of two odd function, product of even into odd. This relation you already know, that what is plus into minus. Plus into minus is minus. Plus into minus is equal to minus. Minus into minus is plus. What is plus into plus is plus. Okay. Now here I'll give a correlation with my plus is even function. This is what function? Even function. Minus is odd function. Yeah. What we discuss up to this, you know that is very clear. Now, product of even into odd is an odd function. Product of two odd function is an even function. Product of two even function is an even function. This operation, everyone you already studied in basic level, you remember this, you give a correlated to minus is odd function, plus is an even function. Okay. Now move to the another next prerequisite is a very, very important. This prerequisite you must and should have to remember, then the Fourier series problems are very, very easy. Next, move to the second prerequisite is definite integral property. Integration of minus a to a f of x dx is twice of 0 to a f of x dx. The condition is if f of x is an even function. Okay, even function. 0 if f of x is an odd function. This is a very, very important. While solving a problem, once you apply that, no need to evaluate. Instead of minus a to a, it is enough to evaluate 0 to a. Suppose function is an even function, half of the range. Instead of minus a to a, it is enough to find out half of the range. Either 0 to a or minus a to 0. Both are must be same. So post-function is art, not necessary to evaluate directly to substance zero. This property is very, very important, but keep in mind, integral limits must be having what actually negative to positive limit. You can't go for this property. Suppose the integral 0 to a f of x dx. It must be, if you want to go for this property, it must be having negative to positive limit. Then only I go for this integral proper, definite integral property. Most of the students, they are doing mistake here. They are not consider this limits. Limit must be start from negative to positive. Okay. Then move to the third requisite. Third prerequisite is very, very important. That's also the point of discontinuity. Third one is point of discontinuity. Now, that here, what's a point of discontinuity? Now here, suppose having, for example, I'm going to consider example, then easy to understand. F of x is equal to e power of x for x less than 0, 0 for x greater than 0. If you want to plot a graph for this, definitely you can't able to plot a graph. You don't get a value at which point? At a point 0. At a point 0. Why? Because the function is not defined. 0 is not included. Here also 0 is not included here. Okay. This shows that now once you plot a graph, you don't get a point at which point 0. We get a discontinuity at which point x is equal to 0. Because 0 is not included here, or suppose included for x less than or equal to 0 or included for greater than or equal to 0, then we say that is continuous. Now, 0 is not included either in the first interval or not in the second interval. Once you plot that, we get a break. We get a break at which point? We get a break at x is equal to 0. X is equal to 0 is a point of discontinuity for the function f of x, for the e power of x for x less than 0, 0 for x greater than 0. The another way for graphical representation to identify is a point of discontinuity or not, whenever having a piecewise continuous. Piecewise means they have a break. Instead of using a discontinuous, they are going to use in some textbook piecewise. Piecewise means they have a break. Then only you are expecting discontinuity. Whenever the continuous having a piecewise, they have a point of discontinuity. Next question is, how to find out the value of the function at the point of discontinuity? For example, I want to find out f of 0. 0, either we can't take e power of x, either we can't take 0. Because 0 is not included in first limit or not included in second limit. 0 is a point of discontinuity. What is a better way to find out approximately the value of the function at the point of discontinuity for x is equal to 0? There we are going to take average of left-hand side limit and right-hand side limit. At which point I want to find out here? 0. That's why 0 minus and 0 plus. Take an average of left-hand and right-hand side limit. That give rise the value of the function at the point of discontinuity. Therefore, now see here how we get. Now observe carefully, left of the 0, x less than 0, what's our function? E power of x. Our function is e power of x. As x tends to 0, means put x is equal to 0, what happened? E power of 0 is 1. Right of the 0 means x greater than 0. What is my function? 0. As x tends to 0, you know limit of the constant is constant itself, 0 by 2. Finally, we get what's a value of the function at the point of discontinuity is 1 by 2. This is a formula to find out the value of the function at the point of discontinuity. Now, keep in mind what are things I discussed today. What are the things I discussed today? If we want a little bit of zoom out, then we have to see entire thing in one shot. Now I consider first what actually the function is, even the how to define even function, odd function definition. what happened, product of even into odd, odd into even, product of two even functions, product of two odd functions. After that, we discuss what actually definite integral property, it must be having negative to positive limit. How to find out the value of the function at the point of discontinuity? These much, and also not only this, another one thing that important, the important is fourth one. The fourth one is actually UV rule or Bernoulli's rule. Yeah, whenever having a product of two functions, there we are going to use UV rule or Bernoulli's rule. Now, for a, what is UV rule or Bernoulli's rule? Integration of UV with respect to X. Whenever having product of two functions, now we are going to use UV rule and Bernoulli's rule. Our UV or Bernoulli rule is says, I'm going to write first the formula, after that I'm going to explain. U into V1 minus U dash into V2 plus U double dash into V3, alternately we get plus minus, where V1 denotes that integrate once, V2 denotes integrate twice, V3 denotes integrate thrice. U dash denotes differentiate once, U double dash denotes differentiate twice, etc. Now, if we want to, this is actually UV rule or Bernoulli's rule is nothing but generalization of integration by parts. If we want to go for this rule, keep in mind product of one of the function must be zero after the few derivatives. Otherwise, what happens? Product of none of the function is not equal to zero up to till nth derivative is goes on infinity. No use to go for UV rule. Now the next question arises, how to apply UV rule? One simple example I'm going to explain here. The simple example, for example, x squared into cos 3x with respect to x. Now I want to find out integration of x squared into cos 3x. Before going to consider UV rule or Bernoulli's rule, first I have to identify which one is U function, which one is V function. Compare x square and cos 3x, x square is 0 after the second derivative. Now we are going to choose x square is our U function. The remaining as V function. This is the way I have to choose U and V. Observe, compare both the function, which function is 0 after the few derivatives, you treated that as V. Compared to another one, which one is early 0, you treated as U function, remaining as V function, okay? Yeah, you have a doubt, ma'am, suppose we are going to take some, both the function is maybe 0 after the few derivatives, what happened? Observe, which one is early 0, you choose that function as U, the remaining as V, okay? Now from this formula, what formula says now, x square into, what is integration of cos 3x? Cos 3x is nothing but sin 3x divided by 3 minus plus minus first derivative of x square is 2x. At second integration, but you already integrate once, again integrate, what is integration of sin 3x? Minus cos 3x divided by 3 square. Again we get another, the quotient of x is 3. Plus derivative of second derivative. We already know the first, again find out derivative of 2x is 2. Again I integrate V3. We already, this is second integral of cos 3x. Again integrate minus of, what is integration of sin cos 3x is sin 3x by 3, we get 3q. Yeah, we are going to stop to apply UV rule or Bernoulli's rule until you reach derivative values constant. What's the next term actually? Minus. What is derivative of constant? Is 0. Even though this is non-zero, we get actually integration of sine is, we get minus minus into minus plus cos 3x divided by 3 to the power of 4. But no use. Product of one is non-zero, whatever this value must be 0. keep in mind where we are going to stop to apply UV rule or Bernoulli's rule. Once you get derivative value zero, derivative value is constant, then we have to stop. Not necessary to go for further step. Here we get derivative value is constant. This is the last term of integration of x square cos 3x. You multiply and simplify that. We get integration of x square into cos 3x. Now, if you want to go for UV or Bernoulli's rule, keep in mind product of one of the function must be a zero after the few derivatives. Otherwise, no use to go for UV rule or Bernoulli's rule. Even though have a UV rule or Bernoulli's rule, in some of the case, we are going to use integration by parts, especially for first year. You already studied how to find out integration of cos to the power of n of x, integration of sine to the power of n of x. Here, even though have UV rule, Bernoulli's rule, we are considering what actually integration by parts. We can't say always UV rule or Bernoulli's rule is work it out. Whenever having a polynomial with finite number of power, there I go for what actually UV rule or Bernoulli's rule. Now I think it's clear every prerequisite, totally I consider four prerequisite. One is even or odd function definition, definite integral property. The third one is how to find out the value of the limit at the point of discontinuity. Fourth one is how to apply UV rule or Bernoulli's rule. Thank you very much for listening my talk. I'll come and meet you in the next class. In the next class, I'm going to explain what's the formula for Fourier series, how to apply Fourier series, and then where to discuss in my further classes. Okay, thank you very much. Bye, see you, take care.